Hello, good morning. Today we are going to start the paper first. Chapter first, basic electricity and network theorems. Okay. So, basic electricity means, so in any circuit there are three components. The first component is a source. Okay, it is a voltage source. It may be AC, it may be DC. Okay, as in the circuit, there is another component is the current I, which flows through the circuit. And third one is opposed, produced by the circuit. Okay, so these are the three components. So this total oppose of the circuit is known as a resistance R. So this is nothing but oppose. So we shown by it this by zigzag line. So this is nothing but a resistor. It shows opposition. Okay. It oppose the current flow. So these are the main three components in any circuit. The voltage source versus the electron flow or source is the current. Okay. So the negative terminal is the source of electron, so electron flows through the circuit through the resistor and ends up its journey up to the positive potential of the voltage source. Okay, so this current shown by electron flow, the electron flows, so like this is called as electron current, and there is another current, that means it is for our convenience. The current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal of battery, and this is known as a conventional current. Okay, so this is a conventional current. So it is easy to represent that the current flows from higher potential to lower potential. That's why it is known as a conventional current. But electrons flows only. Electrons flows from negative terminal of battery and ends up its journey up to the positive terminal of the battery or voltage source. Okay, so these are the three components of the any electric circuit. Okay, so the regarding this, there is a law which is known as Ohm's law. Okay, regarding with these three components. Okay, so there is law which is known as Ohm's law. So here in this circuit, so applied voltage V or whatever the current produced in the circuit is proportional to the applied voltage V. As we increase the voltage, current increases. As we decrease the voltage, current decreases. So I is directly proportional to V. So we know that this is the Ohm's law. So we can write is here V equal to I into R. So this R is known as the proportionality constant, and this R is nothing but a resistance of the circuit, which is given by R equal to V by I, we know that, and the unit of the resistor is Ohm. So this is a simple Ohm's law. Okay, the current flowing through the circuit is directly proportional to the applied voltage provided resistance in the circuit is constant. That means it is a constant. Circuit in the resistor is constant. If this is true, then I is proportional to V, directly proportional to the applied voltage. So that's why this is known as a proportionality constant, so that this R we consider, this R considered as a constant. Okay, there is no change. So R equal to V by I. If we increase the voltage, there is also increase in a current. Okay, so for the same R, if you observe the relation between current and voltage, if we increase the applied voltage, there is an increase in a current through the circuit. So this is the relation between current and voltage variation. So this indicates the Ohm's law. Okay, so this voltage means it is a electric pressure. Okay, we can say that is a potential difference. So that potential difference और सम टाइम इट इज नोन एज EMF, इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स। ओके, सो दिस इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स EMF और पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस और इलेक्ट्रिक प्रेशर फोर्सेस द करंट टू फ्लो थ्रू द सर्किट। ओके, द करंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अप्लाइड वोल्टेज V। सो दिस इज नोन एज ओम्स लॉ। द करंट फ्लोज थ्रू द सर्किट, एक्चुअली वी नो दैट द करंट फ्लो थ्रू द सर्किट दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ ओनली इलेक्ट्रॉन। सो इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्लोज थ्रू द सर्किट। ओके, सो दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रॉन करंट। ओके, एंड कन्वेंशनल करंट इज द करंट दैट वी फॉर आवर कन्वीनियंस वी कंसिडर दैट इट फ्लोज फ्रॉम हाई पोटेंशियल टू लो पोटेंशियल, दैट इज नोन एज द कन्वेंशनल करंट I। ओके, सो अनदर मेन पॉइंट इज यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज यूनिट ऑफ कन्वर्जन्स। ओके, सो दिस किलो मीन्स 10^3, मेगा मीन्स 10^6, गीगा मीन्स 10^9। ओके, एंड द लोअर यूनिट मिली मीन्स 10^-3, माइक्रो मीन्स 10^-6, नैनो मीन्स 10^-9, एंड पिको मीन्स 10^-12। सो दिस इज अ फ्रैक्शनल यूनिट एंड दिस इज अ हायर यूनिट्स। So you have to know all these conversion units. Okay, so we know that we have to convert kilo ohm to ohm. Okay, or we can also write some ohm into kilo ohm unit. Okay, so these are some examples are given. So here 1.5 kilovolt, that is equal to 1.5 into 10^+3 volt. So K means we write K, that is 10^3 in place of K. So it is 10^+3. So 1.5 into 1000, 10^3 means 1000, that is equal to 1500 volt. Okay, so 1.5 kilovolt means 1500 volt. Okay, similarly we can convert this in milli. So okay, 2800 milliampere, that is equal to 800 10^-3 ampere. Okay, so only you have to write in place of M, you have to write 10^-3. Okay, so here it becomes 2800 into 10^3. It is -3, so we have to divide it into 10^3. That means we get 2.8. So 10^-3, so you have to shift this point to the three divisions left. 1, 2, 3. Then it becomes 2.8. So it is a 2.8 ampere. So this is the unit of conversion. You should have to know about that. So this is some information type content. Okay, and the sources of electricity, AC source, DC source, then it is signal generator, alternator, it is sources of AC, so UPS. This is the informational type the content you should have to know. And this is a DC source. Okay, so this is a DC source, we know that battery, DC generator, rectifier, DC source, these are the DC source. So this is the internal impedance of the source. So directly we shift up to the formulas of this. So these are the important formulas you should know. Okay, directly we start from this one. So these are just informative type, so you can just read about that and directly we shift to over there. Okay, RT equal to R1+R2+R3. If the resistors are connected in series, then equivalent resistance is the addition of three resistors. Okay, if these are in parallel, so 1/RT equal to 1/R1+1/R2+1/R3. Okay, if two resistors R1 and R2 are connected in a parallel, so this is the parallel sign. Okay, so you can write 1/RT equal to 1/R1+1/R2. So overall the formula becomes like this. RT, if the two resistors are connected in parallel, then we get R1 R2 divided by R1+R2. So this is the useful formula. If two resistors are connected in parallel, so this is the combination. RT equal to R1 R2+ divided by R1+R2. Okay, so this is the formula if the resistors are connected in parallel. Okay, when R1 and R2 are connected in series. So this is just like a potential divider formula. We know that. We already saw this potential divider formula. So R1 upon R2. So if you find the if you want to find the voltage across R2, then you have to write in the formula R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into applied voltage V. This is the VR. If you are going to find the voltage across R1, then you have to write R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into applied voltage V. Okay. So that depends on which voltage do you want. If the voltage across R2, you can write R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into V. So like this. So that means the resistor that you are going to find out the voltage across, that you have to put in the numerator. If you find the voltage across R1, then you can write here R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into applied voltage. Okay. If the two resistors are connected in parallel, then in that case the potential across both the resistors is same. Okay. The voltage for both the resistors is same. The voltage is same, but the current is different. If you observe here, if the two resistors are connected in series, then current is same. Whatever the current flowing through the two resistors is same. Okay. Current is same, but voltage across each resistor is different. Okay. You can find the voltage by using this potential divider formula. These are the most important and useful formulas. Okay. If two resistors are connected in series, in that case current flowing through the resistor is same, but voltage difference. So VR2 and VR1. So here, if the two resistors are connected in parallel, the voltage across that is same and there is a different in a current only. Okay. So these are the main important formulas. Then other than one is a power. Okay. So power is nothing but a work done by the electron. It is the rate of doing electric work, that is nothing but a power. So work done by the electrons, that's why it is known as the power. So it is the rate. Okay. So here it is the rate of doing electric work. It is rate means what? Okay. So how we are going to define the power now? Now let us see here how you are going to define the power. So power, as by the formula, by the definition, it is the rate of doing electric work. Okay. So rate of doing means, suppose this is the work, electric work, per unit time. Okay. So per unit time, that means it is a work done per unit time. Okay, so that is nothing but a power. We know that V is work done by a unit charge, Q. Q is the charge, so W is the work. So this is the voltage. Okay, the voltage is nothing but a work done by a unit charge. Power is the work done by per unit time, that is the rate of doing electric work. And then we can write here. So here we just keep some modification. So W equal to V into Q. Okay. And what is I? I is nothing but a current, and it is defined as the flow of charge per unit time. Okay. The rate of charge flow, that is nothing but a current. The electron flows here in the circuit, electron flows from negative terminal. If the more number of electron flows, that means there is a more current. So like that, if the number of charge flowing per unit time, okay, that is nothing but a current I. Okay. So we can write from here, we can write T equal to Q by I. Okay. Then just this W and this T you have to put here in this equation, then we get another equation, that is P equal to V into I. Okay. So W equal to V into Q, and that is T equal to Q by I. So if you put these two values in here, we get P equal to V into I. So this is the power equation. So again we can write P equal to I square R. So if you put V is equal to IR, then you get I square R. Okay. So if we put I is equal to V by R, then we get here P is equal to V square by R. Okay. So these are the power equations. So this is the basic equation. Power is means work done per unit time. Voltage is the work done by unit charge. Okay. So I is the current, means it is the rate of change, it is the rate of electric charge flow, that is electron flow per unit time. Okay. So this is nothing but a power. Okay. So there is another law, like Ohm's law. There is another law which is known as Kirchhoff's laws. So this is also most important law. Okay. So this is basic law and it is mainly used in different circuit. Okay. So Kirchhoff's laws, there is one law which is known as KCL. KCL means Kirchhoff's current law. Okay, so what it shows, so there is a common node. Okay, common node means a point where the electric connections are made. Okay, so this is the common node. Then what Kirchhoff's current law states, suppose there is a current, one current which is flowing inside the node, there is another current which is leaving from the node. So consider this is current entering into the node I3. So this is also entering into the node current I4, and this is a leaving from the node, that is say I5. So in this case, simply we can write the current entering into the node that are equal to current leaving from the node. If we take a sum of the currents entering into the node, so which are entering into the node? I1, I3 and I4. So if we take algebraic sum, sum of these currents, I1 plus I3, okay, plus I4, that is sum of the currents entering into the node is equal to sum of the current leaving from the node. So which are the current leaving from the node? So there is I2 and I5. So I2 plus I5. So this is nothing but a Kirchhoff's current law. It states that the sum of the current entering into the node, that is equal to sum of the current leaving from the node. Or again we can say the modified equation, that is algebraic sum of the current at any node equal to 0. So that means I1 plus I3 plus I4. If we change the side, then it becomes I minus I2 minus I5, that is equal to 0. So this is the current law. So you can define anyway. This is the equation. So we can say that the sum of the current entering into the node is equal to sum of the current leaving from the node. Then there is algebraic sum of the currents, that is equal to 0 at any node. So this is common node. Algebraic sum of the current at any common node equal to 0. Then second one is the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, so there KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law. So there is a closed loop. Okay, closed loop means as the current starts from the positive terminal of battery, it ends at the negative terminal of battery. So this is known as a closed loop. So there is no any open connection. Okay, if the current start from the voltage source V from positive terminal, it flows through the circuit and they meet at the negative terminal of the battery, same. Okay, so this is the conventional current. If the current flows through this circuit, so this is same, the voltage developed across this resistance R1 is say V1. Okay, so this is the V1 voltage drop across the R1. So this is the resistance R2. Voltage drop across this R2 is nothing but V2. So this is resistance R3. Then voltage drop across the resistance R3 is nothing but a V3. Okay. So then how we are going to write the developed voltage polarities? So start from the positive terminal. So you get the first end, then you write the positive, and the negative, another is at negative terminal. So then first, so write here positive and here negative. Again, if you continue up to this, this is the first is at positive potential and second is at the negative. So like this, you have to mark the polarities, that is the voltage across the each resistors R1, R2 and R3. So this is positive terminal. Start from positive terminal of battery. The first terminal is positive, second terminal is negative. So you have to mark the polarities like this. Okay. Then Kirchhoff's voltage law said that addition, okay, algebraic sum of the voltages developed in the closed circuit is equal to zero. So you can write here. So V1, V2, V3. So these are the, so if you start from this terminal, you get the positive. You get the positive. That means these are the having same polarities. So that's why you can write here V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay. So this addition of these three is equal to the applied voltage V. So you can write this same way like this. Okay, this is the first simple statement is like this. Addition of the developed voltages equal to the applied voltage. So these V1, V2, V3 are the developed voltages. Okay, so from this applied voltage V. So in that case, the addition of the developed voltages around a closed loop, okay, equal to the applied voltage V. And again, you can write the same thing. So V1 plus V2 plus V3 minus V equal to 0. So like this. Okay, so you can write the equation for this. Okay, so the statement becomes now the algebraic sum of the voltages around any closed loop is always 0. So this is a closed loop. If you start from this point, you ends up their journey up to this. Okay, it is a closed loop. So algebraic sum of the voltages around any closed loop means the V1 plus V2 plus V3, and this is minus V. Why minus? If you start from the journey, we get the first positive, we get the second positive, again this is positive. Okay, if you start continue, you get the negative here. So that's why you have to write the negative. If you start from this point, okay, so first you positive, then positive, then positive, and then here you get the first negative. So that's why you have to write the minus V. So like that, so you can write the statement for this. Algebraic sum of the voltages around any closed loop equal to 0. Okay, and for this we can write the sum of the voltages in a closed circuit, that is equal to applied voltage V. So both are the same. So the voltage, so you can write the sentence for this equation also, or for this equation. For this equation, the applied voltages is the applied voltage is equal to the addition of the voltages developed in the circuit. Okay. So here the algebraic sum of the voltage around any closed loop equal to 0. So this is nothing but a voltage law, and so this is Kirchhoff's voltage law and current law. So these two laws are very important. Okay. So up to this we started the first chapter. Okay, now we are going to stop here and continue in the next lecture.